let's go outside. It's rainy, even she doesn't want to go outside. Happy Monday, I think. This is my last full day hanging out with the dog, the sister dog. It's cold, it's rainy, so we actually might just stay inside and read today, which is super lame for vlogging purposes, but you know, it's gonna be a solid choice. The only thing that I didn't realize is my mom doesn't really seem to have like any choices for hot beverages, and like that would be perfect on a day like today. And I don't have hot beverages on a regular basis, so I don't even think of bringing them other places, but I just feel like a cup of tea would be like perfect. Curled up with a book, she's a blanket I love, and a cozy couch, and it's gonna be a good day. So I started something new I thought I would show you, which is basically this little journal. And basically, it's gonna be kind of like a travel journal sort of thing, but also for staycations, because those are important too. Long weekends from school, etc. So I started spring break, and then this is actually the wrong day because I put Friday, which is when spring break started, like after work on Friday, but then I wrote about Saturday. But I just talk about like, what did I do? Did I eat anything that was really good? What did I read, and how much did I walk? Because it's fun to see your activity too. And then yesterday I didn't finish any books. I did go to a bookstore, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna write that or not. I guess I should, because visiting bookstores is always something I enjoy. But yeah, I'm just gonna kind of keep track of what I do on vacation and just try and make downtime special, even if it's just like a long weekend from school where you're not really going anywhere. Amelia. Okay, so this is the book that I started yesterday. I'm not very far into it, but it's Reprieve by James Han Matson. Basically, you know that someone was murdered, and it starts off with like an interview with one potential person who was kind of involved in it. What did they witness? Blah, blah, blah. And then it goes into the first character, Kendra, who I believe is one of the people that was there. And she is Black, from like a more affluent family, and it kind of just goes through a little bit about her and her story and stuff like that. Not in the house, just more like before. And then there's like another little like interview with somebody, and then it goes into this other person. I forgot their name. But they're gay, and oh, he's gay and obsessed with a former teacher or professor of his, I think professor, and I think they end up being in the house together. So that's weird, because he's like very obsessed with him, like in a sexual way, and I think the professor is pretty solidly straight. So anyway, we'll see how this goes, but I'm gonna keep reading it. It's a good like gloomy day for this. Okay, one of the things that I really like about this book, that like just something it does, I guess, is at least I've noticed this when Kendra is telling the story. Kendra, remember, is the affluent Black girl. Her father died, and her mom, who is, her mom's a hot mess. Her dad was a hot mess too, because he was obsessed with like being a lawyer, and he never really was home very much. Kendra always felt like he was trying to escape the home just to be working all the time. But anyway, after his death, her mom and her moved to Nebraska, and so she's just describing what it's like to be in Nebraska. And what the author does when they're telling the story from Kendra's point of view anyway is that every character is described by their race. So you don't just assume that somebody is white, they're described as white. So Emmy and I are on our mission to see if we can find a muskrat again. We saw one yesterday, basically. We kind of scared it. So it was going down the creek, like we were like facing the creek. So we're like at a 90 degree angle, I guess, kind of to the creek. And so we scared this muskrat. So it like goes really fast, like flop, 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 did this floppy swimmy thing, trying to get away from us down the creek, which is fine. But then it turns, so it's like going like directly at us at full speed. And I thought it was like
charging me. Like, I've never been charged by a muskrat before. But apparently there was like a little like water drainage gate or something, like, you know, the little grate things, and it went into there like as fast as it could. But for a second I thought I was being charged by a muskrat. Okay, so this is where we were last time we saw it, and we scared it, and then really loud when it was coming towards me I said, oh, not nice word, oh, not nice word, oh, not nice word, really fast. But see that like grate thing? That's where it went. So it went like flop, 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 oh, try to get away, and then full force towards us, but only to go in that grate. So luckily we were safe. I don't see it now.
I just finished this. It was intense. So here's the thing. I really enjoyed it. I found it compulsively readable, and I just read, sat in my dad's chair and read for a really long time, which usually I'm distracted. So that is a really good sign that I did that. Let me just tell you more about this book, because I think the last time I told you about it, like, I didn't really know what it was about. So basically, there's this guy who has created this extreme haunted house. And basically there are two groups a night that go through the house, and they it has to be a team of four people. So there's two groups of four people that go through every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, something like that, on the weekend basically. Every weekend, although it is closed during the winter. I think it opens again in March. So I think like October or November, they close. Basically, these people go through the house in order to possibly earn $60,000 as a group. So $15,000 per person that can make it through. The name Reprieve is like the safe word, and they're allowed to say it at any time and the game will end. But basically there are five or six cells that they have to go through. So it's like different rooms that have a different theme. There are really legit actors that work here. They come from all over, like they're legit trained actors who participate in this as like the people doing the scaring, and they are allowed to touch them, the contestants, which is unusual because usually at haunted houses, the people doing the scaring are not allowed to touch the guests. But yeah, so they enter a room, there's a clock going, and they have a certain amount of time to find envelopes within the room while they're being scared. And the directions always say like, oh, there's a first aid kit behind the clock, because people do get hurt because they are allowed to be touched and tased and all sorts of crazy stuff. Actually, it doesn't say tased, it says shocked, which I don't know if that's a more mild version of being tased. So anyway, they also in the directions will say like, you need to find this many number of envelopes in order to like pass this room or whatever and move on to the next room and the next level. And basically what happens is you go through each of these rooms, and if you make it to the end, there's this ghost that they have invented, and in her hand she will have two envelopes, I think. And if what you have found in your envelopes matches one of the items that she has in her, I think it has to match both the things that are in her envelope, then you win the $60,000. So not only do you have to get through it without saying the code word, you also have to have what's in your envelopes match what's in hers. Because like maybe there's 12 envelopes in a room, but you only have to find 8 to pass. So it is possible that you could pass all the levels and not have anything match what the ghost has in her envelope. So anyway, basically no one even makes it to the end, let alone wins, because it's so horrible. tons and tons of blood. It's definitely a horror book. Now, so yeah, I would say it's compulsively readable. My only quibbles with it, I guess, are maybe the way it's marketed. So I believe that it's called a literary novel, and I'm not sure that I would call it that. I think that basically the author, James Hahn Mattson, he tried to have a lot of discussions of things that are going on in our society. So obviously greed and the desire for money is a huge theme in here. And then there's lots on race. There's loads and loads of times that race and racism is being discussed. But to me, it kind of feels forced and not quite so natural. Like, I really enjoyed the part I mentioned earlier where one of the characters, she would describe someone based on their race when it was the story was told from her point of view. And I liked that. That felt natural to me and like something that needs to happen more in books. But some of the other discussions I just felt like were placed in order for this book to be teaching you something. So if you want to have a good time, I think you should read it. Like, I definitely think that maybe Heather and Sean would like this book, but don't read it as a literary fiction. Just read it for fun. And yeah, I think that is important, because if you expect a literary fiction, I think you'll be extremely disappointed. This idea of going through these rooms and finding these envelopes and trying to defeat the ghost has given me a bit of an idea that I might do for summer or for the month of May. I don't know. Anyway, which is, I have loads of unread books that are in my collection that I'm trying to get through because I want my TBR to be lower, reduced. So what about if I hid envelopes in certain books with like a little like summer icon or something in them? And then I would collect my little envelopes with my little pictures as I read books. And then they would just be randomly placed in different books. I don't know how this would work exactly. And then at the end of said time frame, either the end of the summer, the end of May, whatever, then I would pull out my pictures and see if I found a picture that matched the picture in another envelope that I like separated, and then I could win a prize for defeating my TBR or to like for like reducing it. But I don't know what prize I would want, because I don't know, I just kind of like just buy stuff when I need stuff, so I don't know. But I think that would be real fun. So if you think it would be fun, you should let me know.